Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released watchOS 7 public beta. This is the same as watchOS 7 developer beta 4. So you'll have all the major changes that come along with watchOS 7, and I'm going to go over those in this video, but I also want to tell you how you can install watchOS 7 on your device using the public beta. Now keep in mind, if you install this, there is no way to go back to watchOS 6 without sending this into Apple. So be very careful if it's something you depend on, or you can't afford to have some bugs, do not update to this particular version. Wait for it to come out to the public later this year. Now, watchOS 7 public beta is pretty nice. It has a bunch of new features. And if you want to install it, the first thing you'll need is obviously an Apple Watch. You'll need a Series 3, Series 4, or Series 5 Apple Watch. This is no longer compatible with previous versions. So you'll need 3, 4, or 5. Series 1 and 2, unfortunately, will not work. This is a Series 4 Apple Watch. So let's talk about how to install it, and then we'll talk about what's new. If you just want to jump to what's new, I'll link those in the description below so you can jump to that particular point in the video. Now, the first thing you'll need is your connected iPhone. So whatever iPhone is connected to your Apple Watch, pick that up. Then you want to go to Safari, and then go to beta.apple.com, or you can go to apple.com/beta, and it will bring you to this website. Now, this is what it will look like after you log in. You will first need to sign in with your Apple ID. Once you've signed in, you'll be brought to this page. And once you've been signed in and accepted any of the terms, what you want to do is tap on watchOS. Scroll down until you find you can read all about it, and it talks about feedback and everything else. And then you want to scroll down until you find enroll your Apple Watch. So get started, but make sure you read this first, understand what you're getting into. And the idea is to try out some early features so that you can provide feedback and help Apple make it better. Now tap on can enroll, or tap on enroll your device. Once you've tapped on that, scroll down, then tap on download profile. Wait for it to say allow, go ahead and hit allow, and you'll have the profile. Tap on install, and then you'll have the profile installed. It will reboot your Apple Watch. And then what you'll do is check for an update on your Apple Watch, or you can actually check for an update in the Watch app itself. So if we go into the Watch app, you'll see I already have the beta profile installed. So you can scroll down into your main settings and see profiles here. So you'll see I already have it. And then what you want to do is go into your Watch app, go to general, go to software update, and it will check for an update, and it will see watchOS 7 and install it. You need to have a 50% charge and have it on the charger unlocked in order for it to install. Now, if you want to revert to a different version or get off of the public beta, what you need to do is uninstall that profile. So go to your settings under Apple Watch, scroll down, go to profiles, tap on the profile, then remove the profile. Once you've removed it, it will reboot your Apple Watch, and you will not be able to get off of the beta until the next public version comes out. So currently 6.2.8 is out, maybe 6.3 or 6.2.9 will come out. Once that does, that will get you off of the beta. So that's the only way to get off of the beta without sending it to Apple. So again, just a warning, don't put it on your device if you need to be on watchOS 6 or depend on it. Now let's talk about what's new. And so the first thing that's new are some new watch faces. And so you can see here, this is the new Chronograph Pro watch face with a tachymeter or tachometer. And you can tap on the watch face and it'll give you your different dials, or go back. And you have a bunch of different color options for this as well. It may default to blue or white depending on which version you're on, but they've been changing this around if you're in the betas, and you'll see it's a new watch face. Now, this watch face may or may not be available depending on the series watch you actually have. There's also a new watch face for extra large, where you can now add different complications to it. So you'll see I have the world here. So if I tap and edit, before you could only have the time in a large size. Now we can add complications. And so we can scroll through the different complications that we have, and there's some new ones as well. And we'll talk about some of the new complications they've added in just a moment. Now, the next thing is Photos has some options. There's also Infograph Modular, but Photos has some options. And if we go to Edit, Photos now has filters. So if I want to change the color of the photo here, you can do that by going through different filters. So you have a bunch of those, and then, of course, move the position around to where you want to see the photo. Now, also, there's some new Pride faces. So there's Pride Digital and Pride Analog as well. And so you have those as well. So you can tap on them and they sort of wave. So that's kind of interesting. And then again, they do the same thing on this watch face. So there's just a bunch of new watch faces. There may be some more things for you to explore as well, but let's take a look at the new complications. And there's a few of them. So we'll go to our complications and edit. And one of the first new ones is a camera remote. So now you can remotely activate the camera on your phone. I think you could bring this up before, but now it's just a complication. So it's nice that they've added that. They've also added Siri shortcuts, and you can now add individual shortcuts. So this is just a shortcut I have, but there's a few of them, and you can add a few different shortcuts if you'd like, scroll through them in the app itself, but now you can just have one button to access that shortcut. We also now have a world clock complication. We have a sleep complication, which we'll talk more about in just a moment. And we also have a moon phase complication as well. And so those are the new complications within. Now, apps can have multiple complications as well now. So you can create maybe your own infographic here with multiple complications from the same app. So you'll see I have two activity apps complications right now. So you can have two of the same, you can have multiple ones. So for example, maybe you have the weather, you have one with humidity from a weather app, maybe one with the temperature and one with, say, the forecast in it. You can have multiple from one so that you can create your own watch faces later on. And once you've created those watch faces, you can now share them by pressing and holding. So you'll see there's a little share button down here once you press and hold. And then you can share it in a message. So you can share that with anyone that has an Apple Watch. They'll be able to use the watch face as long as they have your installed app. So that's a really nice way to share those. And then you'll be able to access those apps within the App Store and find new ones. So I'm not sure they've updated it yet. So eventually there will be new watch faces within the store so that you can download a bunch of them that people have created. So I'm glad to see more customization with watch faces, and it's something that they've added throughout with watchOS 7. Now there's a new sleep app. Like I mentioned before, there's a complication, but there's an app dedicated to sleep. And so you can set this up as, say, your bedtime, a wake-up time, and you can wear this and track your sleep with your phone if you'd like. You don't have to do that, but you can, and then it will remind you to charge the battery in the morning. Also, it will remind you on your phone when your battery needs to be charged with a notification. So it will just pop down on the phone. Also, when it's fully charged, it will notify you now as well. So it's a nice little app to have here. And then you can track it within health if you really want to monitor your sleep. Now in this update, there's actually new workouts as well. So there's four new workouts. And if we scroll through here, we can see some of them. We'll wait for it here. And you'll see these are all the normal ones. Functional strength training is one of the new ones. So you have that built in. You also have dance now. You have cool down, and you also have core training. These four are all brand new. So that's built in, and it's really nice to see that. Also, Siri can now translate in different languages. In fact, 10 different languages. So let me bring this up here, see if we can activate Siri. How do you say hello in French? And so it will translate 10 different languages, and it does it right on the watch now. It doesn't have to send it out to the internet to translate it, and it will work in Japanese as well. So we'll try that. How do you say hello in Japanese?
In Japanese, hello is konnichiwa.
So you'll see that it's been updated again with 10 different languages. So I'm sure they'll add to this in the future, but right now it's just 10. Now also, there is cycling within maps. So if you use the Apple Map app on your watch, you can use it for walking and things like that, but they've added cycling. We'll wait for it here to get the maps. You can get cycling directions. So maybe you want to get a direction somewhere, you'll have the option for cycling now. So let's see if we can search for a place. And you'll see that when we search for, I just searched for a nearby fast food place, but you'll see that we have cycling directions. So we now have that option, and it says it's not currently available for cycling, but it will be added later on, and we'll be able to use it for cycling and find things along the way. So it's nice that they've added that. Now, another new feature they've added is battery health. So if we go to settings, and then we scroll down to where it says battery, tap on battery, it will give you your current battery state, its usage overall, and then if you scroll down a little bit, you've got battery health. And here you'll see I'm at 81%. Now this is a couple of years old at this point almost. And so 80% after 2 years is normal. And so you've also got optimized battery charging as well. So unfortunately, there's not really a battery replacement program for Apple Watch. So I'm not sure how this will age, but we'll see what Apple does in the future. But it is a new feature that's here. I wish it would just say good or bad and then tell you when it needs to be replaced. Or I guess in this case, I have to replace this Apple Watch. Now we've had the Noise app for a while now with watchOS 6, but now it has more functionality where it will help monitor throughout the day and let you know in your health app if you've been exposed to loud sounds for some time. So there's more information here with it. Nothing particularly new with it, but finally, there is one other feature you've probably already heard about, and that is handwashing. So built into this is handwashing, and you can actually access that on your iPhone. So in the Watch app on your phone, if you scroll down a little bit, tap on hand washing, you can turn the hand washing timer on. So anytime you start to wash your hands, it detects it, and then also will give you a reminder if it senses that you're at home. You don't have to use that, of course, but it requires location settings enabled for that to work. But it will give you a timer every time you wash your hands. Now, I've actually had some issues with this. It's supposed to count down 20 seconds, and it works sometimes, but many times it will stop at, say, 14 seconds and no longer continue. So I'll be washing my hands, and it just sort of freezes. So it is still in beta. Keep that in mind. And if you're having issues, report them in feedback on your phone, and make sure that you're just reporting any issues you find so that you can help Apple make it better, and then it will be better in the next updates for you. So those are all the major features. There are other small changes throughout, so have fun exploring that and finding those. And of course, if there's major changes with beta 5, I'll mention that in the next video. If not, I'll wait until there's more changes. But let me know what you think of watchOS 7 so far. What device are you using it on? Of course, if you'd like to get the wallpaper I have on my iPhone, I'll link it in the description below. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.